where'd you get that passion from? Is it just like your love for spices, or is like was it growing up? Like what gave you that, no pun intended, but what gave you that heat?
I used to be a chef for 2 years at a local restaurant in Boston called the Smoke Shop Barbecue. And we only did barbecue sauces for the table. We never had like our own hot sauces. So me and the owner decided to say, hey, let's try to put some hot sauces. People keep asking us if we make our own hot sauce and we should like offer some type of hot sauce. And you know, me and him like made a Reaper sauce together, right? And it was like a hot Reaper sauce. Like I had to go to the table and like have him sign a waiver. Like, hey, just so you know, this is what's gonna happen. You need to sign this. Wait, Falco, I have a quick question. What's hotter, the ghost or the Reaper?
The Reaper. The Reaper is 4 times hotter than the ghost.
But they love that shit though. They love, man, people love that shit. They're like, sign my life away to eat this. Oh, bet I ain't no pussy. Sign it, give it to me. People love that
That's
shit.
what they want to see, you know. That's what
Yeah,
they want to see.
they
It's,
love that.
yeah, they'd be like, oh, you know, when you got to sign the paperwork for a hot sauce, you know it's good.
Yeah, so they go tell that story like to 20 more people later and be like, yo, I remember this one time I signed this paper. It's like skydiving. It's like that thrill of like danger, you know? That's
Right.
like they're like, oh, I this is dangerous. I love it. You know what I mean? Not me. I see danger. I'm like, I'm on the block.
I tried it. I was like, look, so literally with this hot sauce, it was so like spicy that not only did we have to do that, but we had to train our staff how to handle that hot sauce, right? Like if you're the one pouring the hot sauce into a ramekin to bring to the tables, you got to wear like at least two or three gloves, you know. Grab the bottle, pour it in a ramekin, then take the gloves off, wash your hands thoroughly, and then like grab that plate. Don't even grab the ramekin again. Grab the plate, you put the ramekin on, and then bring it to the table, right? That's the server or the like whoever's handling that. But then when they're cleaning the table, you got to make sure that when the server drops off that Reaper pepper, right? The server has to tell the bussers, like, hey, there's a Reaper pepper on that table. Don't forget and just put it in the dish room because this happened twice over there. They took this little ramekin that had just like the oils from the Reaper pepper. So the dishwasher goes and sprays it and all those fumes comes out and it looked like a tear gas went into that kitchen. Everybody like had to get out of the kitchen because they couldn't breathe. They were like crying. And they just were all coughing that spice up. So yeah, this spice is dangerous. So that's like kind of like the process of dealing with peppers. Like even when I'm dealing with like certain people that ghost, I had to be careful because if I like processed it and touched my face, oh.
I just want to hear your take, Falco, on like what it's like being first gen, what it's like, you know, from your perspective, how you went through that journey. You're still going through it, and so are Jose and I, but what's your take on being first gen? What is that experience like? What does it mean to you?
It means, you know, that you started with your family from the bottom in America, and they want to go up, they want to see you go up. So it's your turn. If they started here and they build up to here, you got to take what they build and keep building on top of that, right? So like that, if you get up to here and your kids are up there with you, and now your parents are like, you know, chilling because now you're taking over and like helping them out, right? And then now, like, your kids are gonna be, imagine that, like, just like, and you keep going, right? Like, you keep going. That's how, like, back in the days, people that started a business ended up making money for that business. It's not for them, it's for like the future generations to come. Like, they're gonna keep their family alive. And I think, being first generation for me, like that's what it is. Like my mom and my dad were first ones to migrate here, right? And I was first born. So they had to like get regular jobs like that were they probably didn't pay well, you know, but you know, they struggled and they had to adapt and they went through some harsh time because in that area when they were here, you know, there was a lot of stuff happening, you know, when it comes to like being Latino or being black or being Asian, like, cause they all, like, you know, we all went through it in a different way, you know? So to me, it's like, hey, it's just like a motivation to just get out there and like not get absorbed by what people really think about us or what people see that some people like don't grow out of the neighborhood, right? Like some kids get stuck in the neighborhood because that's the lifestyle they're used to and that's what their parents are used to. So their parents are never gonna be like, slap them on the side of the head. Like, what are you doing? Why are you on that corner? Get out of that corner, go to school or go get a job if anything, if you don't wanna go to school, right? They're just gonna be like, nah, that's okay. But some people have kids that the family's still doing that, but the kid doesn't wanna do that. So that's when they move up and like try to like, hey, I'm gonna go to school or hey, I'm gonna start working now and saving my money so I can buy a house or something, you know, or I could build something. And it's just part of like just getting out of that zone and being open-minded, like learning, like you guys probably learned from Austin, right? You probably learned from Brendan. Liam probably learned, I mean, Brendan learned from Liam. I learned from a lot of people that I surrounded myself by. And I try to surround myself by a lot of people and learn from them. Like, if I could grow with that person and grow as a person myself, then I would welcome any relationship in my life that's like that.
Yeah, well, you think about that. It's like that you surround yourself with good people, but the knowledge, and everyone has like, Austin, we'll just meet Austin for an example here. You know, like I learn a lot from Austin. Austin has his own ways, things that he's teaching me, blah, 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 whatever, right, for example. But the knowledge is only as powerful as like what you do with it. You know what I mean? He has his own, like his own route that he's going in, his own, like it's all contingent on one other thing. Your path and what you do might be completely different than like what you do with the knowledge that he gives you. You know what I mean? And that's what it's all about too. Cause you're not like copying him or anything like that. You're taking his knowledge and you're wrapping it around with your vision and right. Pushing it forward. So everyone's path is unique.
Exactly. And that's why I say, you know, I tell everybody, be open-minded, take in. If you have interest in something or you're finding yourself having interest in something, go experience that. Go meet some people that are already immersed in that and see if you could, you know, take that as a hobby or something, you know. But I think, you know, life is going to be like that. And if you stop growing, you're just going to be the same person you were yesterday. You always got to change every 5 years or so, you know.
Yeah, that's true. That's true, man. That's
yeah, very I think true. For me personally, what being like first gen means, and from my experience and perspective, it just means like I've had access to so many opportunities for growth and learning. And that's what my, you know, 20 something years on this earth has meant and has been for me, like from going to a, you know, all boys private middle school that was, you know, started for underserved boys in the Hartford community, to then going on to a Catholic high school, and then on to Providence College, which is a Dominican ran college, so, you know, Catholic as well. And then, you know, now I'm living in the city, I have, you know, a great roommate, great friends, great support system. Along the way, there was so many important like people who helped me get to each of those respective stages, and a lot of firsts along the way as well. Like, you know, first time, you know, going and trying an oyster, first time hiking, first time skiing, first time going, you know, outside of the United States, besides Puerto Rico, of course. But, you know, I went to Ireland my senior year spring break for college. A lot of firsts that were marked. And, you know, I know all of those things because all of them, you know, it means something special to have a first. Like, you know, a lot of people like take things for granted because, you know, I experienced this. I know what this is like already. But for me, it's like, wow, this is a new experience. So that for being a first generation, that, you know, that's what it means to me, having a lot of first time experiences. So, yeah. I just want to throw my take in there, but I think it's pretty awesome. I think
that's exactly what first generation is, right? Because your parents were born in Puerto Rico, and my parents were born in DR, and yours parent, where Jose, is your parents born in DR or?
Well, no, my mom and dad, they were born in America.
Okay, so as kids from parents that came from another like country that they didn't even speak the language, right? Yeah. Right? They had to like just stick to what they know, you know, making the rice and beans every time, like the making their platanos, you know, with the salami, and like for you to like being in America growing up with that and then going to school and like, oh my God, what is that? Pizza? What is pizza? You know, like, so that's gonna be you your whole life. And at the end of the day, like because your mom is building that same home that she had in her country in here in the US, right? And you're the one that's gonna talk way better English than she is because you're gonna go to school here, right? That means that what you have is different than what they had. That's all it is. And it's just taking on what they kind of blessed you with, because if you look at third world country, like the arch third world country, like they're struggling, you know, they struggle there. You know, I can't imagine myself being born and stuck there, because I would probably like, I don't know. I can't even imagine that. Like, I don't want to imagine that, because it's sad. It's sad. And, you know, one day I want to be able to help that community and help, like, I don't know, get them out of that stage, you know, and help them like grow, because there's no reason they shouldn't be where America is or where every other country is. Why should they be still? It's like 2021, right? It's technology. So they shouldn't be considered a third world country anymore. There's a lot of countries that are considered third world. They should be out of there. There should be enough support for everybody, you know? But yeah, to me, like, that's what it is. First generation. It's like, you go out, it's like, mommy, you want to try sushi? She's like, ¿qué es eso?
Yeah.
Oh, raw fish? Oh, no, I don't eat that.
Nah, I
never tried it. That's what that jerk question is.
But she has the option too, and that's what matters.
Yeah, exactly.
That's...
But they will try it. They will go out.
Nah,
You know what? You got, like, my dad be like, oh, get me a nice cut steak. I'm like, Pops, you know how to eat steak? He's like, I'm like, how you
want to like, he's like, yeah, I eat it well done.
Yeah, I'm like, well, Pops, I might as well get you a pot roast and give it to you wet, well done. You know, you're killing the steak. Yeah. People don't buy ribeye to eat it well done. So, but that's because he's used to eating his steak cooked. He doesn't like seeing the red meat, you know. But I got to be like, Pops, just try it. You know, just try it. You're going to like it. If I gave you or each of you the ingredients for making the Thai bird, I guarantee you that none of you are going to come up with like the same taste of that I do because of the cooking process. I guarantee you, like, I should do that. I should record a video where I'm like,
all right, bet. All right, we're coming over in 20. Bet. Let's do it.
So every time people are going to make it differently. So I'm not afraid of like putting all my ingredients in a bottle because my competitor could buy it. Go ahead, buy it, try it, and try to replicate it because you like it and you want to like make your own. Perfect. You're going to make it your own for sure, but it's not going to taste like mine.
Damn, that was so smart. You're right.
Falco's like, might be Bauce Sauce, but it's not Falco's Bauce Sauce.
Yeah, it might be that rest, like the ingredients in there, but it's not. It's not really, you know.
My man put the philosophy hat on today, bro. He was like, all right, I'm about to school these motherfuckers. Real quick, we're at a buddy's house last night. We're at my buddy Bradley Meyer's house last night. We're chilling, drinking. His apartment in Boston. He's in Brooklyn. And we're all chilling, having a good time. It's a vibe, you know, playing a couple games, relaxing. And to like Barbara's point, there was a point where there was a lull, you know what I mean? And I was just like, all right, I'm fucked up. It is what it is. Like, it's not, it's like seven dudes, six.
Yeah.
You know, just nothing to do. And then I just remember looking at Barbara and Barbara looking back at me and giving me a little wink. And then he was like, hey, you guys like hot sauces? And these and these motherfuckers went bananas. like these guys, you might as well have just been like, yo, you guys want to order food out or something like that? They were like, holy shit, hot sauces? Get the fuck out of here. Like I got it on me. Like, yo, it's right here. Y'all want?
So I open my jacket. I start whipping them out. Like, he's like, how many you got in there?
You
want three today.
You guys planned it all along.
You might as well have already told them, like, yo, I can give you 60 for an ounce. And they'd be like, whoa. You know what I mean? Like, they were like, wait a minute. You know what I mean? But, yo, he pulls out the hot sauces. He's like, yo, and we don't just got one. He's like, we got two more over here. And they all come up. And then we're like, all right, we're at best. So we're like, we go in the kitchen, whatever, and we need something to put it on. You know what I mean? I'm like, fuck. Like, what do you put with hot sauce? Me, I don't know anything about hot sauce. So I'm like, fuck, what do I do? How about this orange, this banana? They're like, no, you need like chips or something. So I was like, meat, like you got to cook it. So I put the meat away, we get chips. Brad has like these fucking like crumbs in a bag. And I go, everyone's like, fuck it, let's do it. You know what I mean? I'm like, all right, it's because you guys cool, your hands getting dirty. Yeah. So we take a plate out, whatever, boom, we lay it out. We put the sauce, boom, hot, boom, medium, boom, whatever. We put them all there. Get the chips out. We get our little bags. We all putting in there. I go, all right, guys, you guys go first. Good luck. And they're like, salute, because if these shits are hot, I ain't trying it. You know what I mean? So they grab some chips. They put it in there. And they just look at both of their faces. And they're like, damn, this sweet. Damn. Oh. Damn, it's hot. Like, you just see it slowly dying in themselves, you know what I mean? And they start trying all the flavors and start trying everything out, and they're like, damn, this shit is good. You know what I mean? And I go, give me this motherfucking chips. I grab the chips from them, grab from the bag. I start trying out this shit. I'm like, you know, I know it's hot. I'm getting ready to, I have the tissues next to me, I'm ready to cry. I start putting it in, and I'm like, damn, this shit is really nice, actually. And I tried the mild one or the medium one or the next one, and I was like, damn, this is something really good. I would put this on my meat. I was like, shit, this shit is actually really good. Again, let me get a chip, boom. Try the last one. Like, and I looked at all the guys. I go, damn, these are fucking wicked good. And they're like, great, right? And I said, an idea pops in my head, and I go, listen. Because I know how this is going to affect, you know, the future. I go, listen, I'm going to give you all three of these sauces right now. They're like, what? And I said, we about to give you all three of these sauces right now. I look at Barbara. I go, I'm going to pay for all three of these sauces right now. Just give them the sauces. And they're like, really? And I'm like, yeah. And then they start cracking more chips out and they're eating it. And they're like, dude, who made this? Who's is this? And like, they're like, yo, they have these motherfuckers giving like checking, yo, follow here, follow there, checking shit out. Yeah. They Venmo me for the fucking, I gave them the sauces. I said, don't fucking, I got them. I'll give the money to Barber because they were his. And the Venmoing me like fucking money to pay for it. I just gave it back to him. I was like, yo, here you go. Yeah. And they were like, yo, we're on his subscribers list right now. Like, I want to buy more of these. I want to buy five of these packs right now. Right now.
Send them to my store.
Falco, is there a – because this is blown up with the kind of the hot sauce craze. Do you have a truffle hot sauce maybe on the horizon somewhere?
Damn.
Or is that too main? Is that too mainstream? Is that overdone, overplayed?
You know, I did try that. I tried this truffle. I actually enjoyed it. You know, one of my things for snacking at my house, I have like a lot of Asian essentials in my freezer that I just whip up and stuff. But one of the other things I like, you might be like, oh my God, like you eat hot dogs. Like I like hot dogs. Just having like a real beef frank, like not just like, you know, the hot dog that's just like $2.
That's classic.
Buy my hot dogs like cost like.
Yeah, the Glizzy King. $8.
Yeah. There's like when you bite into it, that's that juice. You know, it's a real hot dog.
I love. Oh so yeah, yeah.
I like literally put truff on that, and it was like really good.
You put
truff, mayonnaise and ketchup. Yo, and it tastes so good.
No, Jose's laughing for a whole different reason.
Jose's laughing for all the wrong reasons, Father.
I know exactly. I know he is. Take your mind out of the gutter, bro.
Put the truffle all over those glizzies. Hey, you know, what are you talking about? I fucking love hot dogs too, man. That shit's a fire, bro.
Why is he laughing?
Go ahead, Barbara. Do the outro.
Yeah, for sure, Falco. You know, we appreciate you coming on, man. I think first and foremost, it's been real. Like, you gave us a real raw perspective of just being an entrepreneur, first generation. But most of all, I think for all of us here, it's been relatable. So I really do appreciate you coming on. And, you know, the viewers are going to like this one. This is a good one.